Hi folks, in today's video, I'm continuing my series on grounding. In my last video, I discussed what lightning is and its energy levels. The link's at the end of this video. Today, I'll discuss how grounds are used to protect buildings from lightning strikes. There are three main methods used to design lightning protection systems. They are the rolling sphere, mesh, and protection angle methods. All get you to the same place with different equations. I prefer the rolling sphere method. Here is the rolling sphere design method in picture form. The idea is to have the arc of the sphere only touch the lightning rods as you roll it over the structure you're trying to protect. It should always be suspended by the lightning rods and never touch anything you wish to protect. The higher the protection, the smaller the sphere, and naturally, the higher the cost of the system, since more lightning rods are needed. Note the minimum charge protected against. Each level of protection really has a range of protection, and they don't start at zero. These minimal charges are stray fields during a strike and/or static in the air produced by the storm, but not delivered in the lightning strikes. This minimum level is the value used for sizing surge protection. So, the solution is to build our system in such a way as to make sure the energy goes where we want it to, into the lightning rods and down into the soil. Everything else is secondary. Recall from my last video, absorbing the energy is problematic since it's so large. Also recall, lightning is a pulse, so inductance matters. We're designing an inductive divider with high inductance above the top of the soil and low inductance below the soil. Soil is mostly made up of air gaps. It's very porous. So, soil by itself is not a perfect ground, but we want to do everything we can to make it so. Remember, we want low resistance and low inductance. If we assume 0 volts at the water table level, in this picture it's 15 feet down, then from the top of the soil down to the water table, the earth is a very poor conductor. Treating the soil is only half the battle. It only reduces the resistance. Horizontal copper mesh or copper straps interconnecting the multiple ground rods is needed as well. Copper straps in parallel with the ground rods will also help, although this is hard to achieve without lots of excavation. This will build a three-dimensional low inductance cube. This is where you want to spend your money. Having as close to a perfect ground to dump the energy into is the goal. Note, a single round conductor will produce about 1,000 volts per foot when hit by the average lightning strike. In this example, 15,000 volts at the surface of the soil to the water table. As always, if you'd like help with anything related to power, give us a call. We're here to help. Thanks for watching.